Well, let's go ahead and get started. We allowed a few extra minutes to allow folks to come back for lunch and things like that. So first of all, and foremost, welcome. Thank you for carving out a couple hours this afternoon to join us for this first inaugural innovation with the city of Anaheim. So one thing I'd like to do right away is thank Devin Marino and Trevor for sponsoring us as their excellent partners to come out and share a great day of innovation ideas with you all. So again, appreciate that. I think it's pretty clear by now we have some refreshments, water, and goodies on the right. During the whole presentation today, please feel free to get up. You don't have to wait till the end of the presentation. You can dash over and dash back. It's fine. And we're going to take a break about halfway through. Two reasons. If you sit forever, it's like, we got to get up and move. And we have basically exhibits that go into the details of the talk style here today. You can go ask specific questions and discuss with our subject matter experts. So why are we doing an innovation day? HP partnering with the city, providing IT services, has actually been working innovation pilots for the last couple of years. So we've been exploring new ideas to reach out and involve all the departments in what we're doing so we can take feedback and grow. And at the end of the day, Grace Gu, our innovation team leader, we have an internal portal that we're going to open up to city employees to be able to capture and collect your ideas. So this is intended to be an interactive, fun day. We've got frisbees. I got a head scratcher if you need that. I got all sorts of good stuff here today. So before we get started, I'd like to hand the microphone to Devin for a couple of words.
Okay, go ahead. Thank you for your time. So we really hope that at the end of the day, you'll found your investment valuable. This is what we hope is going to be the first in a series of opportunities to get together and talk with HP and the city's IT team, get folks together to talk about innovation, give you an opportunity to network with each other, talk, maybe have some fun along the way. I know that doesn't always sound like it can happen.
Hey, IT geek is chic. Come on, it's good.
Yes, please. So anyway, we're just looking for some opportunities to leverage IT and innovation to help provide our various and, you know, very diverse stakeholders in our community better service and processes. You know, we're looking to help out the citizens, the businesses, and our thriving tourism industry. So with that, I'm going to turn it right back over to Cliff for his geek is chic. Hopefully you guys have a lot of fun and learn
something.
Thank you.
Yes, applause. We do the ball. So yeah, a couple things. So this, like I said, is the inaugural Innovation Day. It's actually patterned off our colleague account down here from County of San Diego. We have some of the folks presenting. Actually running from their innovation team are up here, and they have found it just to be a really great bit of dialogue. So we're going to try to do this twice a year, in the fall and in the spring, and if successful, we'll repeat it year on year. But we also have some other ideas besides the portal, which Grace will talk about at the end. Is I think most folks know HP's on the fourth floor in this building, and we've carved out a little space, and we hope to have some semi-permanent exhibits for some of the ideas that we are taking forward and developing. So if you have a specific interest, you can call me up. There's phone numbers on all the giveaways, the collateral here today, and or send us an email. Just come on up, hang out. We call it the Innovation Lounge. I'm not sure we'll be serving after 5 o'clock, but maybe we can work on that. Okay. So the structure of today, I kind of run everything over, is we have one overarching talk to kick us off. Dr. Amit Shah from HP Labs. Not surprising, HP has a large R&D investment, not only for all our products, but also our services team. And he's going to talk about some work that's been going on about thinking way far ahead for cities, what's important and how technology can support that. And then we have seven structured talks, hopefully they're quick and lively, sort of TED Talk style, about areas that are important to the city of Anaheim, quality of life, public safety, enhancing the tourism business, and then building the infrastructure. So we've tried to group these talks for those specific areas. I know some of the folks have to leave early. If you miss something, I think we're taping, and we're always happy to go back and review that. So without further ado, details, things to follow up. Not only will Amit be around to discuss during the break and after, but also emails are on all the
that is the sort of the futuristic overview and backdrop. We're now going to focus in on a couple of topics that are germane to that. One that was touched on is this notion of mobility and different platforms and things like that, and how we're already innovating in Anaheim. So where's Dave?
Next, because what we're going to be displaying and showing you here is a 4x18-foot wall, which is sort of hard to fit in a suitcase and bring out to Anaheim. So we have Scott Bourgeois in Plano, Texas. Scott, are you there? Can you hear me?
Hello, good afternoon.
All right. So Scott is actually going to talk about using touchscreen interfaces for command centers. Now, Scott is actually a visualization project engineer and manager of this technology, which actually involves some of the things we've touched on so far. Different data sources, the analytics that go into them, and then using display technology to convey results and outputs and outcomes. So he's going to share a little bit. One thing that we have already been working on with the city for quite some time is support for the Emergency Operations Center, where you could think a command center would fit right in. But there are also other applications. We're going to go through that today, and Scott's going to take us through. Thank you, Scott, for that very informative presentation. I should mention that a lot of the technologies that we're talking about today, the foundational items like AirWatch is already being implemented in the city of Anaheim. So some of the things you can think about, if you're interested in the end result, some of the foundational stuff is already happening today, so it's not that far off. And we're pretty excited about that. It's part of some of the projects we have going on now. So, okay, now we're going to turn it over to Jan Eastus. One of the things that we've talked about this for some time is, imagine self-guided tours at a convention being presented at the convention center. You could just enable the app, and for a particular convention, you could find what you're looking for, get a list of the exhibitors. There's a lot of possibilities. We're going to continue on with more of this managing large data content and doing analytics. And so Jan's going to come back up again. And she touched on this briefly in the talk on the video surveillance, where now we're going to talk about that sentiment monitoring management analytics.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Jan. So we're going to wrap with our final formal talk on an infrastructure application of innovation and technology, actually based on a pilot we've done here that started a couple years ago, but how that's evolving and how we would like to take it forward. And then we'll be closing with, as I spoke at the top, about how you can participate, provide feedback, and engage in innovation with the IT team. So I believe Michael Machiavelli is going to start. And then, so that concludes the actual detailed dive into some of the innovation ideas. So to close, though, as I mentioned on a few occasions, reintroduce Grace Gu, who